study about the force between two parallel current semiconductors, and this is my new YouTube channel, that is Physics with Fun. And for those who have not subscribed yet, please do like, share and subscribe my channel. Okay, spread love, God bless. Thank you. So guys, before proceeding, let us learn some new terms. That is, what do you mean by the magnetic force acting upon a charged particle? Okay, when the charged particle is present inside the magnetic field. So this is the relation between the magnetic force and magnetic field. That is, FM is equal to Q over into cross product of velocity of the charged particle and the magnetic field. So we can write this, where L vector is the unit vector that is along the direction of the magnetic force. So we can say that according to right hand speed rule, this magnetic force will be perpendicular to the velocity, and also it is the perpendicular to the magnetic field intensity. So we can say that by combining all of this, this magnetic force will be perpendicular to the plane containing magnetic field and the velocity of the charged particle. Okay. So let us see how will be the trajectory of the charged particle while it will enter into the magnetic field. So we can say, if this is the direction of the magnetic field, that is the external magnetic field that we have applied. Okay, let us, it is B. So B will be in the x direction or x axis. So here it is a charged particle, that is Q. So now we have to project this charged particle perpendicular to the magnetic field. So the velocity will be in the y axis. So angle between this velocity and magnetic field will be equal to theta is equal to 90 degrees. So how the force will be experienced? First of all, as we know that the force will be perpendicular to the plane containing velocity vector and the magnetic field vector. So it will be just like this here. Okay. So finally, when at initially the charge is here, when it starts moving, just after some time the magnetic force will be exerted here. So it starts bending. Okay. So it starts bending, and after like this, at this point also, it will also get some magnetic force due to this magnetic field. So like this, it will make a circular trajectory. Okay, it will make a circular trajectory. So this is a circular trajectory, that is the path followed by the charged particle while it will enter perpendicularly to the magnetic field. So we can say that if theta is equal to 90 degrees, so magnetic force acting upon it will be, or the magnitude will be QBB sin 90 degree. That is equal to QBB, that is equal to magnetic force maximum. Okay. So we got it. But except the perpendicular or normal condition, if we project the charged particle into other angle, then it will follow the spiral path. But actually this will, this is not our motto, or this is not the purpose of finding the trajectory of the charged particle. We just have to explain what will be the magnetic force between the two parallel current conductors. So current is coming, that is the opposite to the electron. While the electrons are moving in a straight direction, then the current will be flow in the opposite direction. That's why in the previous video I have already explained that the electrons, while flowing in a metallic conductor, then the magnetic field arises outside the conductor. We have to draw a long straight infinite current carrying conductor. Okay. Actually, we don't know the exact value of this length, so we just take it undefined value. Okay, and this is the infinite long straight conductor. Now, to find the magnetic field around this current carrying conductor, so we have to first establish the current, that is current I, which is flowing upward direction. Okay, so magnetic field will be created like the circular loop. So now we have to find the magnetic field at this point P. Okay, so we can say that if the current is flowing in the y axis, so by the right hand thumb rule, we can say that here at this side, where the point P is established, the magnetic field will be inward normal. So, for the inward normal, we take this symbol, okay, cross symbol. So, just take it. Now, suppose this is the point A, where the current is starting, okay, and this is the end point, that is B. So it will be like this, and this is the fixed distance, that is D. So we can say that D is perpendicular distance. Okay, here this is the 90 degree angle. So suppose here is length limit, that is DL. Okay, so DL vector is along this direction where the current is established. Okay, so now take a position vector from this length element to the P. So it will be like this. Okay, suppose this is the R vector. So position vector direction will be towards the P. Okay, and this length, suppose it is L. Okay, suppose this is the angle theta. Okay, so this will be what? This will be pi minus theta, or we can say that is 150 degree minus theta. Okay, so now this will be a right angle triangle. Okay, so we can say that L square plus D square is equal to R square according to Pythagoras theorem. So exactly like this, we have to make, or we have to draw the position vector from point B towards the point B, and say from the point A to the point T. Okay, so suppose this is R1 vector and this will be the R2 vector. Okay, suppose this angle is theta 1 and this angle will be theta 2. Okay, so listen carefully. Here this is the constant distance, so we cannot change this distance, okay, between the P and this length element, but we can change this value, this position vector value. According to the Biot-Savart law, the magnetic field at the point P due to this current carrying conductor or the small length element BL will be equal to dB, or dB vector magnitude will be equal to mu 0 divided by 4 pi I dl sin theta divided by r square, where there are three variables like this, where first of all dl, because the length can be changed, okay, and then sin theta, the angle also can be changed, that theta will be changed from theta 1 to theta 2, okay, and then this r square. Obviously we know that the position vector are changeable. Okay, this is not constant, so we can write this. So this will be the equation 1. Now from this triangle we can say that tan 180 degree minus theta b divided by l. So we know that tan 180 degree minus theta will be equal to the minus tan theta, that is equal to b divided by L. So L को यहाँ लेगा, so L will be equal to D divided by minus tan theta, or it will be minus D cot theta. So now we have to take the derivative of this length to find out the value of DL. Okay, so now just taking the derivative with respect to dot theta, we can get delta L divided by delta theta is equal to D, तो यहाँ पर कांस्टेंट हो गया, so minus P, okay, and derivative of cos theta will be equal to minus cos square theta, okay, so minus minus cancel हो गया, cos हो गया, so we get the value of the PL will be equal to D cos square theta D theta, okay, so this is the equation number 2. Okay, finally we get that. And now we have to find the value of r square. Okay, so write r square is equal to l square plus d square. We have to write l square in terms of d square because the d is a constant distance, but l can be varying. Okay, as we know that d divided by l is equal to tan theta. So d is equal to l tan theta. So or otherwise we can say that d square equal to l square tan square theta, or l square is equal to d square cot square theta. Okay, so imply that r square will be equal to in place of l square d square cot square theta plus d square, that is equal to r square is equal to d square common then 1 plus cos square theta. So 1 plus cos square theta, that is equal to d square cos square theta. So r square will be equal to d square cos square theta. And this is the equation number 3. Okay. So finally, we converted all these terms in terms of the angle theta. Now we have to put these values in the above equation 1. So by writing from the equation 1, we can say PD is equal to mu 0 divided by 4 pi I. In place of DL, we can write D cos square theta D theta ideal then into sin theta, okay, ideal sin theta divided by r square. So r square here d square cos square theta, right? So just we can cancel this cos square theta cos square theta. So we also cancel this d to d square. Finally, we get that mu 0 divided by 4 pi I sin theta d theta divided by b. Okay. So this is the magnetic field due to this small length element, that is dl. But now, if we find out the magnetic field intensity due to this current carrying conductor, that is AB, so what can we write? So the theta will be changed, okay, the theta will be varied. So in case of R, this is the continuous function, so we will take the integral of this, okay. So integral of what? DB, that is equal to integration of the current is, in, as you know that the current is moving from the point A to point B. So the angle will be taken as from theta 1 to theta 2. Okay. Now just take the put the value, that is mu 0 I divided by 4 pi D whole into sin theta D theta. Okay. So just see D this value is a constant term. So we can say mu 0 I by 4 pi d integral of theta 1 to theta 2 sin theta d theta. Okay. And this will be like mu 0 I divided by 4 pi d. The integration of sin theta d theta will be equal to minus cos theta theta 1 to theta 2. So mu 0 I divided by 4 pi d. Mu 0 I divided by 4 pi d minus cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. That will be cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. So this is the value of the magnetic field produced this AB current carrying conductor. Okay. But in case of the infinite long straight current carrying conductor, what will be the value? As you know that if we will expand it, then B point will be like towards the upward direction. Okay. So the value of theta 2 will be increases to a limit, that is 180 degree. Okay. So we can write for infinite long straight conductor. Okay, for the infinite long straight conductor, theta 1 will be decreased to the 0 degree, that is theta 1 tends to 0 degree, but theta 2 will be increased to the 1 degree, that theta 2 tends to 180 degree. Okay, so just put this value. Okay, so magnetic field due to infinite long straight conductor will be mu 0 I divided by 4 pi d in place of cos theta 1, that is cos 0 degree minus cos 180 degree. Okay, so here will be equal to, this is 1 minus minus 1, that is 1 plus 1, 2. So the value will be 2, 4 cancel, mu 0 I divided by 2 pi d. So this is the final equation. This is the equation number 5. Okay, so this is the value of the magnetic field at a point due to infinite long straight current carrying conductor. The value of magnetic force acting on a current carrying conductor when this current carrying conductor is present in the uniform magnetic field. So first of all, we have to take a current carrying conductor, that is the AB. So total length is equal to AB is equal to L. Okay. So this AB now is placed inside a uniform magnetic field, that is the B vector. So just we have to take the two bar magnets. This is, this one will be the north pole and this one will be the south pole, and the magnetic lines are from the north pole towards the south pole. Okay, so it will take the small length element, that is dl. So dl vector will be towards the A. So this dl vector now is making an angle theta with the uniform magnetic field, that is the B vector. Okay, so let us see what is happening, actually happening. When this length element, suppose the total conductor now is connected with the backplane having the potential difference, suppose V. Okay, so this is the conductor, this side is A, this side is B. This is the uniform cross section area. Suppose the cross section will be we can say the A, but like this. Okay. So, we can identify the actual difference between this A and this A. Okay, this is the area of the cross section. Okay. So, now this will be connected with the potential battery with the having the potential difference, that is V. switch. Okay, this is the indicator. This is switch, that is key. Okay. And above this is the positive end, this is the negative end. Okay. So the value of the current or the current is flowing from here to the negative potential. Okay. So the electrons also moving in the opposite direction. This is the direction of the electron, and this will be the direction of the current. Okay, current is the positive charges are flowing, but actually there are no positive charges because only electrons are flowing in the opposite direction of the current. So the electric field will be towards the B, that is from A to B. So here we have applied a potential difference, that is B. Okay. So when these electrons are entering, because we are given the external electric field at first, there are some ions, extra ions are present. Okay. So when the electrons are moving inside this, then what happened to the electron? Okay. So it is the electrons are moving. Actually, we are writing the electrons, those are moving from B to A. But actually, what happened? Is this the actual path the followed by the electron? But this is not the right path followed by the electron. If we just see it microscopically, then we can see part. So this will be the microscopical view. So what happened to the electron or the its path? Okay. So just the, this is the electrons are entering into the conductor. So what happened? As we know that there are some free ions created by the external electric field. So these are the ions. Okay. Ions are everywhere inside this conductor. So the when the electrons are moving, then in its path there are multiple number of free ions. So it will not collide with these ions. So it will drifted its path. Okay, drifted like this. Okay. So now here there is also an ion. So it will not cross it. Okay. So it will also again drifting its path. Again drifted. Here is ion also drifted its path. So the velocity acquired by this electron will be known as the drift velocity, and this motion will also fall as a drift motion. This is drift velocity. Okay. So the value of the current will be equal to I is equal to AB, area of the cross section A, V, PP. Okay, this is the drift velocity, and MAVTE. Okay, so what is the actual value of VT? We know that VT magnitude will be equal to E electric field divided by M into tau. Okay, so this is the mass of the electron, this is the charge of the electron, this is the electric field. And what do we mean by the tau? So tau is the average relaxation time. Average relaxation time. As you know, in the oscillation chapter, that SHM is just a hypothetical concept. That is, simple harmonic motion in the practical life doesn't happen. So there are damped harmonic motion. So if we just hang a pendulum here, okay, hang a pendulum here. Suppose this is the ball having the mass m. So it is the mean position. Just we have to take here at the extreme position, and then we have to just hold it. Okay. just they have to clearly move. So then the bob is moving here first, then it will be moving the same distance as from here to here. Okay, so this will be the extreme position. This one is extreme and this one is also extreme position. Okay, but when the time increases, its distance or its trajectory also decreases. Okay, so basically the graph will be like this. So if this one is the bob, so here, okay, at this mean position it will have to be stopped. Okay, so this is the value of time. Okay, it is the time and it will be the distance. Okay, so according to time the distance will be decreases, and this time, okay, is known as the average relaxation time. But if we are taking the small length element, that is the dl vector, then suppose at this small length element there are dq amount of charges present. So dq amount of charges if present in the dl, then the magnetic force will be very small upon it. So df vector will be equal to dq whole into v vector cross b vector. But we can write that v vector will be equal to dl vector cross divided by dq. So we can write dq whole into dl vector divided by dt into d vector. That is, so dq divided by dt whole into dl vector cross b vector. Okay, so now we know that the dq by dt will establish a current. So we can say that, and here the current is flowing, that is capital I whole into dl vector cross b vector. Okay, so this is the value of the magnetic force due to this small length element dl. But if we have to find out the total force due to this current carrying conductor AB, so what will happen? So just we have to take the integral of this small force. So F will be, or F total will be integration of PL, that is equal to. So we'll start from the 0 to L. So here will be the locus 0, here will be the locus L. Okay, so 0 L I whole into dl vector cross b vector. Okay, but at least we have to find out the magnitude. So what happened? Magnitude of total force will be zero to L I d L B sine theta. Okay, so I d L B sine theta. B sine theta is constant. B sine theta and integration of both V L. Okay, so I, this integration value will be L B sine theta. So basically we can say that the total force will be equal to FT vector, that is equal to I whole into L cross P. So just we have to put the value of I here in terms of drift velocity. So we can write that the magnetic force or the total magnetic force will be equal to MAVTE. E whole into A vector cross B vector. Okay. So now in place of BT, we just have to take in A. Okay. E by M into tau, okay, into E, okay, whole into L cross vector B. So finally, here we get the value. Total magnetic force will be equal to in A E square E by M into tau whole into L cross B. Okay. So as you can see, there are the two parallel current semiconductors having infinite length. Suppose we have to just take the finite length, that is this L1, this is L2. So we can say L1 is parallel to L2. Okay. So the distance between them, suppose, is the small d. Okay. So now, we have to first, in the first case, so case number 1, we have to establish the current in both the conductors in the same direction. Okay. This is I1 and this is the direction of I2. Okay. So, while the I1 current is flowing in the conductor L1, then the magnetic fields arises around this conductor, and also when this I2 current is flowing in the L2 conductor, then also the magnetic field arises in the form of circular current, circular loop. Okay. So, when the I1 is passing through the L1, so the magnetic field due to this I1 in the place of the L2 will be inward normal. Okay. So, due to I1, the magnetic field produced is B1 vector. Okay. And while the current is passing in the L2 conductor, so due to this I2 current, the magnetic field at place of the conductor L1 will be outward normal. So this is B2 vector. Okay. So now on to the topic. Now just we have to find out the value of the force. Value of the both the forces. Okay. So first, the value of B1 will be, okay, mu 0 I1, okay, divided by 2 pi d. The A2 vector, A2 vector is equal to the I2 whole into cross product of L2 vector and B1 vector. So what will be this? So this is the I2 whole into the direction of L2 vector will be L2 here J cap. Okay. So we can say L2 J cap cross B1 vector. So B1 mu 0 I1 divided by 2 pi B minus K cap. Okay. So I2 L2 I1 mu 0 divided by 2 pi B. Okay. 2 pi j cap cross minus j cap, that is minus I cap. So the magnetic force dimension term will be like this, if two vector, okay, if two vectors magnitude will be mu 0 I 1 I 2 L 2 divided by 2 pi b. Okay, similarly the here the magnetic field, that is b2 vector, so b2 vector will be equal to mu 0 I 2 divided by 2 pi p, but the p2 will be the outward normal. So for the outward normal, this will be the k cap. Okay, then L1 vector will be L1 j cap. Okay, so L1 j cap, and the magnetic force, that is upon the F1 vector, I1 vector, I1, then L1 vector cross B2 vector. Okay, so here the I1, this one will be L1 j cap cross B2 vector, mu 0 I2 k cap divided by 2 pi d. So mu 0 I1 I2 L1 divided by 2 pi d j cap cross k cap, that is equal to I cap. So this will be the direction of the magnetic force 1. Okay, so finally these two forces are the attractive forces. Okay, so when the current is going in the same direction in between the two parallel current carrying conductors, so they are attracted to each other. Okay, this force is attractive force. Okay, finally this conductor will be like this. This is I1, this is I2. But similarly, if the in the case number 2, if two current carrying conductors having the current in the opposite direction, this is I1, this is I2, then they are repelling to each other like this. This will be the I1, this will be the I2. So this force will be a repulsive force. This one is F1 vector, this is F2 vector. So this force is repulsive, but this force is attractive force. Okay, so this is our final answer. Okay, so please like this video and share and subscribe my channel.